Hey, what's up everyone? This is Bindu Kumar here. In this video, we are going to go through the steps to install Talend version 7.1.1. Talend is an open source ETL tool that is available in both community as well as enterprise version. We are going with community edition because it is free yet will serve a lot of your ETL requirements. I'm going to show you where to download it from, how to install it and set it up. I had posted another video a few months ago on how to install Talend, but I decided to do another because the setup files have now changed from a .zip file to a .exe file. So let's get started. Talend needs Java Development Kit in order to function. So first we'll go ahead and download the JDK. So to do that, I'll open Google Chrome and search for JDK download. The very first link takes me to the Oracle's website, so I'll click on that. Now here, the latest version of JDK is version 11.0.1. But please take notice, Talend is not fully compatible with this. So I would request you to scroll down and pick the one prior to 11.0.1, which is 8U191. That's right here. So I'm going to click on the download link under the JDK. Now that takes me to the download section. Here, make sure you click on the accept license agreement and you'll have to pick the file that is for your platform. So I'm on Windows 64, so I'll click on this last file over here. Now you can see the download started, but I'm going to cancel this because I have already downloaded the file. You can pause the video here and wait until you have downloaded the JDK and then you can resume. Next, I'll show you where to download the Talend files from. So head over to talend.com. You will find the link for both the JDK and Talend in the description of this video. Okay, so if I scroll down, I can see the section here. I'll click on Downloads. Now you'll have to pay attention here because there are a couple of sections here. Many who want to try Talend do the mistake of going for this free trial. The free trial, as the name suggests, is a trial version. But what we need is the free version, not the trial. So if you scroll down, the very first section that you will see is Talend Enterprise Products. Skip this, head over to the second section, which says try these free products. Now under this, the first thing is data integration. And this is what we want. So click on download free tool. Now that takes me to the data integration page. Here there are two links available, Windows or Mac. I'll go ahead and click on Windows. Now there's a thank you page and meanwhile the file download has begun. It's 755 MB. Again, I'm going to cancel this because I've already downloaded the file. You can pause the video here and you can resume once the download is complete. So I'll head over to the download section. Here I have the Java file that I downloaded as well as the Talend file. First, we will start with Java. Double click on the exe file. It may take few seconds for the installation to begin. Okay, so on my computer, it detects that it's already installed and it's asking, would you like to reinstall it? I'll go ahead and click on yes. If you are doing the installation for the first time on your computer, it may take a little longer. All right, so Java is completed, or rather, JDK has completed installing. I'll click on close. Now we can move over to Talend. I'll double click the file. It's a .exe file. Click on yes. Now here it's asking for a path where to extract the files. This step is very important. Please make sure that the destination folder or the path that you select is as short as possible. This is because there are some folders and subfolders within the Talend extracted files. Also, there are some files that have a pretty lengthy name. So a combination of lengthy file names and long paths don't go so well. In fact, Windows may not be able to support such a long path name for any of those files. So what I usually do is I create a folder in either C drive or D drive. On this PC, all I have is C drive. So I'll go to C drive and make a new folder. We will call this folder TDI, short for Talend Data Integration. Select this folder and click on OK. Now this is my path. Click on Install. Now you can see that the exe file is around 700 MB. So it's going to unzip all the files in the new folder that we created. Okay, so the file extraction is complete. We can close this dialog and head over to the C drive to the path that we created. So here is the folder, TDI, that I created earlier. Open that and you will see another subfolder with the exact same name as the .exe file. Now, if you go within the subfolder, you see all these files. Now, what I'm going to do is select all of these, do Control A, cut, and then paste it one level above here. So I'll just select do this for all current items, continue. Now I'll delete this folder because it has no files in it. Okay, so I did this so that we have a path that is as short as possible, right? It just says CTDI. Now once this is done, you can double click on this particular file if you are on Windows, which is tos_di-win-x86_64.exe. Double click on that. So as you may have guessed by now, TOS stands for Talend Open Studio and DI stands for Data Integration. The first time you launch it, it will take a little bit of time to check all the dependency, sort of consolidate all the libraries. So here click on accept. And you can just click on finish. Okay, so here you see Talend trying to launch, direct you to its website. But that's an optional thing, you really don't need it. So I'll click on close. We can get back to the installation. And there you go. So Talend has completed all its pre-checks and it has opened the designer. Now there's one more step left to do, and I'll show that to you in just a bit. So this is the welcome page. You can click on close straight away, or you can click on next if you want to see some tips. Now as soon as you open Talend, you will notice this progress bar at the bottom right. It says check for extra features installed. Now give this few minutes and it will pop up with a screen. Okay, so now you see Talend presented this pop-up page for additional Talend packages. So by default, the required libraries is ticked and the optional libraries is unchecked. You can leave this as is and you can click on finish. And before you do that, a quick note to those of you who are behind some kind of a firewall or in your corporate environment, you can head over to the proxy configuration, and if your network is using a proxy server, you can configure the host name, the port here. So all you have to do is click on edit, enter your host name for the proxy server, the port, and you can also type in the username password. So you'll have to do that for all the three entries, HTTP, HTTPS, and SOCKS. Once you've done that, change the active provider to either direct or native, click on OK, and then you can click on finish. But here on my computer, this is my personal network, so there is no proxy server or proxy configuration required, so I'm go ahead and click on finish. Now here it presents a list of third-party licenses that I'll have to accept. I can go through each of these and read the licenses, but if you really want to skip all those, you can just straight away say accept all. So the moment I do that, Talend will start downloading those required libraries and installing them, or in other words, registering them within the Talend modules. Okay, so here in the progress window, I can see it says no operations to display at this time, which means all the modules have been successfully downloaded and registered within Talend. Okay, so this completes the installation of Talend. Now watch out for my next video where I'll give you an introduction about the Talend workspace itself. Thank you.